A lot of thoughts going into this wall. Some good, some negative, but let's get into it. Welcome to a brand new video. If you're new to the channel, my name is Noah, and this channel is all about improvement and creativity. And if that's something you're interested in, consider subscribing. In this video, we have some time lapse, some slow-mo, and just a progression of a mural I just did for Citizen Church in Albuquerque, New Mexico. As I stated at the beginning of the video, I had mixed emotions at the beginning of this project for various reasons. This is a wall that I've painted numerous times and was probably earlier in my career. Painting murals was definitely the biggest wall that I had done, and a wall that kind of was outside of my comfort zone, just in the size. I feel like I've gotten so much better in throughout these projects and these walls, and essentially like gone to some pretty dark places in these projects. Whenever these come around, they're always for big events, for Easter, for Christmas, or some sort of conference, and there's a quick turnaround, so they'll have a service on Sunday, and then I'll have to be done by a Thursday or a Friday that same week. And again, so with the size of the wall, that's a tall task, and sometimes the designs are super intricate, so you're grinding, painting 18, 20 hours a day, sleeping at the church for a little bit, and waking up and getting back to it for a week straight. Like I said, I've gone through some dark places mentally, like questioning my career path and my whole existence. Honestly, it's crazy how existential the projects can get when you go to those places. And I don't think it's a coincidence that these are projects done for a church and done for my church. And they've been some of the toughest and some of the most challenging, because there's something to be said about sacrificing yourself and your gifts for what you believe in. And I think I've gotten such a good return, just to use that word for lack of a better term, on the time that I've invested into church and into just serving in that capacity, because I've only been painting murals for a little over 2 years and have just gotten so much better, like exponentially better in such a short amount of time. The growth path has been one that I could never have dreamed of, but all that being said, like I can't take any of the credit, and I think in the sacrifice in me being willing to spend time to work on these projects that aren't always the most artistically fulfilling and kind of never artistically fulfilling, just get that much better technically. And going back to what I said earlier about the mixed emotions, specifically with this design, is the fact that I feel like for the first time in painting at the church, that I am putting my own stamp and actually making art that's going up on the walls. In the past, I've painted various things. I mean, you can see at the start of this video that it said Easter 2021 and had some QR codes. And so a lot of the things are like that, like a photo backdrop or something displaying a new series coming up. And it's more so branding, it's more so for social media, and it's not art. And so this time I was kind of given free rein to do what I wanted, and that's what I did. And I was a little apprehensive, and am still a little apprehensive, because at the moment that I'm recording this, no one's seen it. You know, it's for Easter, and this video is going out on Easter, so I haven't really gotten much feedback from the congregation about what they think, but I'm putting myself on the line just like any other artist. When you make work in any capacity, there's such a level of vulnerability that is involved, and for the first time, that's being tied together with this project. So we'll see if they like I produced. I'm very happy with it. It's right up my alley artistically, tying in the themes of life and death. But also at the beginning, when I was kind of making the design and knowing that I had free reign, I had to kind of consistently check myself, because when you work realistically or work, I shouldn't even say that, but when you work on such a large scale, or when you work in the public eye, there's the ability to kind of treat it as an ego trip. So you may make a design or come up with something that you know people will love, and you know that you can kind of knock out the park, and just to kind of pat yourself on the back and have people recognize you. You kind of, or I had to check myself throughout the process and constantly remind myself what the motivation is, especially when you're doing things for a spiritual reason and not for monetary gain or trying to get further in business. But when you're doing things primarily to send a message, primarily to make an impact, you have to check your ego at the door and kind of just be a vessel, be a funnel, and make what you think will impact people. And it's my prayer that that's the case for this project. It is right up my alley artistically. It's about the sacrificial life, about the death of Jesus and the life that comes from that. It's about self-sacrifice in our lives and how we are most alive when we're willing to lay down our lives and sacrifice ourselves, our time, our money for other people, and how true life comes from that sacrifice. And that's seen all throughout life. Like, that's just a truism that even if you don't believe in God, you believe in something else, like there's no denying that. Self-sacrifice seems to be universal. Giving yourself to a cause bigger than yourself is a sign of truly thriving. Much like anyone else, I've had my own spiritual journey. Grew up in church. Was just like something I did. And then it became real for me. And even when I kind of accepted and took on my faith as my own, I always doubted and always will doubt, and I don't think that's a bad thing. I think that should be welcomed. 1 Thessalonians 5:21 says, "Test all things and hold fast to what is good." And I think that's just a good principle to live by. It's a biblical message, and it reigns true throughout all of life. And I think it even applies to testing my beliefs about God and Jesus and the Bible itself. And the crazy part is, if something is true, then it will continue to reveal itself as true to you, if that's the case. But I'll always test it, you know. I'll always read other things and just kind of try to obtain whatever knowledge is out there to just find truth and find the right answer. What I plan to do for the rest of my life, I'll read anything, I'll consume pretty much anything with the intent of testing it and seeing if it's true, because if it's truth, then it will stand the test, you know. But at this point in my life, and the things that I've researched and things that I've seen and experienced, there's no doubt in my mind. Maybe in another video I can kind of go into some of those things, or just talk about how I've come to this conclusion. But we're coming to the end of the design, and I figured I'd speak a little bit about it before the video wraps up. As you can see, the flowers on the outside are black and white. They're lifeless, and they're made to portray just like a mundane existence. Inside the crown of thorns, inside of sacrifice, inside of death is where true life comes. Kind of like I stated earlier, giving yourself to a cause bigger than yourself is where you find fulfillment. Shout out to Johnny and Diego for coming through and helping this and helping getting this one done. Happy Easter, whatever that means to you. Let me know if you like the design. As I post this video, I'll be getting some feedback, and really excited to see what everyone thinks, and if it had any, if it resonated with anyone. But let me know what you think down in the comment section. Like, comment, subscribe, all the good stuff. It gets said all the time, but it really helps the channel. And the channel is definitely not the biggest, but the goal is just to grow the community and keep improving, because that's what this channel is all about. So thank you for watching. If you made it this far in the video, I really appreciate it. But happy Easter, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace. The climb. Oh no.